Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to online classes and have a pleasant morning to all of you. Now dear student, I Ajay Kumar, your English teacher, is going to complete this chapter subject verb agreement. As we have read two topics earlier, now we are going to read the final topic of this subject verb agreement. Okay, so we have what we have read earlier, that was agreement of person of the pronoun in the present tense, and then we have read agreement of person of the pronoun in the past tense and future tense. These were the two topics which we have covered in earlier week. Now this week we are going to complete this topic, this chapter, with the topic is agreement in other constructions. Now in agreement in other constructions, like, there are many rules, regulations which you'll see while writing any sentence. So that was the two topic which we have covered, that was related with the pronoun and with the tenses, like present tense, past tense and future tense. Here in this topic we are going to see other nouns and collective nouns and certain nouns. Okay, let's see. So the first rule says, a collective noun that is considered as single unit takes a singular verb. Now listen it quietly and try to understand it. A collective noun that is considered a single unit takes a singular verb. Now what we'll look for the collective noun first. What is collective noun? And it should be considered as single unit also, and that's why it is taking singular verb. So let's see, in the example we can see what is the collective noun. The hospital staff, as we know, when we say staff, that represents a collection of people, collection of employees who work, right? So staff is being compared or considered as a collective noun. And since even we call a single person that he is a staff of this school, again it is considered as a collective noun. But in that case it will take a singular verb, that is called was. What will be if it will be considered as plural? Write down the answer in the comment section. If it is considered as plural, what will be the plural verb it will take? Though staff being as a singular, a collective noun, it is considered as a single unit. So that's why it is taking singular verb. One more example is given, the jury has found him guilty. The jury has found him guilty. So here the jury is a group of people, let's say 2, 3, 4, 5, but the jury is being considered as a single unit. That's why it is taking single verb, and that is has. Okay, now let's move to the another rule, that is a collective noun where the members of groups are considered individually. It says a collective noun where the members of the group are considered individually takes a plural verb. Now what are the examples? Let us go and see the example. The board of directors. So actually board of directors, it is a collective noun. But it says a collective noun where the member of the group are considered individually. Right, now let's see, the board of directors are divided on the issue of reforms. So when we are saying the board of directors, it means like there are more than one man, there is more than one member in that board, right? But it is being considered as individually because they are giving their vote or decision individually, not collectively. So when this happens, like collective noun, which is considered individually, that time the sentence will take a plural verb, as you have seen here in the example. Next example is, the members of the committee are unanimous in their decision. So members of the committee, right? Members of the committee is a collective noun, but since they are taking their decision unanimous, akele le rahe, so that's why it will take plural verb. So what is the twist here? The twist here is that when a plural, collective noun that is representing a single unit, it will take singular verb, and a collective noun which is considered individually, then it will take plural noun. So single unit means he is representing the whole group of that staff, but still he is being counted as a single unit, right? But in the second rule, we can say the decision they are taking, that is considered individually, that's why it is taking plural verb. Now let's see, move to the another third rule, that is certain nouns that have the plurals ending with s take singular verb. For example, news, measles, physics, athletics, there are many, maths, right? There are many examples you can see. So example, we can see athletics is quite popular among students, right? If any noun which has which is looking like as a plural, because in the end, if that is ending with s, then make sure that will take only singular verb. Another example for this is, the news on television this morning was totally depressing. Now let's move to the another rule, that is certain nouns ending in s take plural verb if they refer to group or a pair, right? Certain nouns, certain noun ending in s takes plural verb if they refer to a group or pair. If they refer to a group of pair, ये key point है यहाँ पे, इसको आप ध्यान में रखेंगे. कुछ ऐसे nouns जो हैं, वे group की बात करते हैं या pair की बात करते हैं, तो वो जो है sentence में plural verb लेते हैं, right? So his spectacles are broken. Spectacles like जो goggles, चश्मा जो होता है जो हम पहनते हैं, that is called a spectacles. तो spectacles जो है pair को represent करता है, उसमें दो glasses होते हैं, right? Shoes, you can say shoes. My trousers are always too tight, right? तो ये group को represent कर रहा, trouser group को represent कर रहा, that's why it is taking plural verb. Now next rule is, pronouns such as both, few, many, several, etc. take a plural verb. Do remember this, very important. जो pronoun है जैसे कि both, few, many, several और ऐसे और भी etc. जो मतलब pronouns होते हैं वो हमेशा plural verb लेते हैं. Now we can see several new products were several. Here it is coming several. Several new product, तो several आ गया, तो यहाँ पे जो verb आएगा वो क्या होगा, that will be plural, okay? That will take plural verb. Many were evacuated, okay? From the collapsed building. Now let's move to the another rule. The titles of books, magazines, etc. take a singular verb. जितने भी book, magazine या newspaper के जो title होते हैं वो singular verb लेते हैं. Example, for the Arabian Night is a famous collection of interconnected stories. The Times is a political magazine. ये जो हेडलाइंस वगैरह आपको दिखते हैं या टाइटल्स जो दिखते हैं जब भी सेंटेंस में आएगा, तो मेक श्योर दैट इट विल टेक सिंगुलर वर्ब एंड नॉट द प्लूरल वर्ब, ओके? वो प्लूरल वर्ब नहीं लेंगे, सिर्फ सिंगुलर वर्ब लेंगे. नाउ नेक्स्ट रूल, वर्ड्स एंड फ्रेजेस दैट रेफर्स टू एन अमाउंट ऑफ मनी, फ्रैक्शंस, डिस्टेंस, इंटरवल्स ऑफ टाइम एक्सेट्रा टेक सिंगुलर वर्ब. अब ऐसे जितने भी वर्ड्स हैं या फ्रेजेस हैं जिसमें आपको ये दिखता है कि उसमें पैसे की बात हो रही है, फ्रैक्शन की, बंटवारे की बात हो रही है, दूरी की बात हो रही है, इंटरवल्स की बात हो रही है या समय की बात हो रही है, तो वो सिंगुलर वर्ब लेंगे. हमेशा याद रखना है आपको. नाउ 20 किलोमीटर्स इज, इट्स नॉट लाइक 20 किलोमीटर्स आर, यहाँ पे मीटर्स है तो आप आर नहीं लगाना. क्यों? क्योंकि 20 किलोमीटर्स जो ऐसे वर्ड्स होते हैं या फिर ऐसे फ्रेजेस जो होते हैं जो कि बात करता है पैसे के बारे में, फ्रैक्शन के बारे में, डिस्टेंस के बारे में, इंटरवल्स के बारे में. तो यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं कि इन दिस एग्जांपल इट इज़ टॉकिंग अबाउट डिस्टेंस. सो 20 किलोमीटर्स इज अ लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस वर्ब, तो इसलिए जो है ये यहाँ पे अकॉर्डिंग टू रूल सिंगुलर वर्ब लेगा. नाउ 15 मिनट्स इज नॉट टू लॉन्ग टू वेट, 15 मिनट्स आर नहीं होगा, 15 मिनट्स इज नॉट, लास्ट में एस है तो बोल सकते हैं सर यहाँ पे तो प्लूरल है तो एस आर आर लास्ट में तो आर लगेगा. नो, इट इज़ नॉट लाइक दैट. ओके, इट जब भी हम फ्रेजेज या वर्ड्स की बात करते हैं जो अमाउंट ऑफ मनी, फ्रैक्शन के बारे में बात करता है, टाइम के बारे में बात करता है, तो ये सब जो है सिंगुलर वर्ब लेता है. नाउ लेट अस मूव टू द अनदर पॉइंट. नेक्स्ट रूल, क्लास नाउंस दैट रेफर टू क्लॉथिंग, फर्नीचर, स्टेशनरी, इक्विपमेंट, कटलरी एक्सेट्रा सिंगुलर वर्ब्स, ठीक, सिंगुलर वर्ब. ठीक है, तो ये जो क्लास नाउंस होते हैं जो फर्नीचर की बात करते हैं, फर्नीचर एक क्लास है, स्टेशनरी भी एक क्लास है, इक्विपमेंट्स, ये सारे जो है सिंगुलर वर्ब लेंगे. एग्जाम्पल फॉर वी कैन सी वेयर इज़ द सिल्वर कटलरी विच वॉज बाउट लास्ट ईयर, वेयर इज द, तो सिल्वर कटलरी जो है क्या है आपका, एक कटलरी सेट है, और ये किस तरीके का नाउन ले रहा है, सिंगुलर नाउन ले रहा है, दैट इज. फिर उसके बाद नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल, द फर्नीचर वाज, द फर्नीचर एक क्लास है और सिंगुलर नाउन ले रहा है, फर्नीचर वाज क्वाइट ओल्ड सो वी डिसाइडेड टू रिप्लेस इट. नाउ लेट्स मूव टू द अनदर रूल, रूल नंबर 9, द वर्ब मस्ट अग्री विद द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ अ सेंटेंस, नॉट विद द वर्ड्स that are close as part of a phrase that comes between the subject and verb. Now in this rule, the rule says जो verb है वो subject of a sentence, जो मतलब sentence का जो subject है उसके साथ agree होना चाहिए, न कि not with the words that are close as part of phrase, न कि उसके साथ जो as a part of phrase उस subject के मतलब verb के नज़दीक आ रहा है. ओके, या सब्जेक्ट और वर्ब के बीच में आ रहा है. एग्जाम्पल फॉर वी कैन सी, स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव रेड दिस बुक आर फ्यू इन नंबर्स. नाउ वी कैन सी स्टूडेंट्स, तो स्टूडेंट्स ये जो है सब्जेक्ट है, तो इसके अकॉर्डिंग जो है हम लोग वर्ब लेंगे यहाँ पे. अब हु हैव रेड दिस बुक, ये क्या हो गया आपका, क्या हो गया, इट्स अ फ्रेज which does not make complete sense, it is making half sense. तो यहाँ पर बोल सकते हैं this book है, तो this book तो singular है, एक book के बारे में बात किया जा रहा है, तो क्यों नहीं is लेगा. No, according to rule, what the rule says, the verb must agree with the subject of a sentence, ना कि subject और verb के बीच जो sentence phrase आ रहा है उसके हिसाब से यहाँ पर subject नहीं होगा. ओके, यहाँ पर subject उसके हिसाब से नहीं होगा, subject वर्ब के, वर्ब जो यहाँ पे होगा इसके हिसाब से होगा, सब्जेक्ट के हिसाब से. अनदर एग्जांपल वी कैन सी, द कैप्टन ऑफ द टीम एज वेल एज ऑल द अदर प्लेयर इज हैप्पी. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं द कैप्टन ऑफ द टीम सिंगुलर, यहाँ पे प्लेयर्स है, तो ये भी बोल सकते हैं सर यहाँ पे प्लेयर्स है तो यहाँ पे तो आर होना चाहिए. नो, सब्जेक्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस कौन सा है, कैप्टन ऑफ द टीम, दैट इज सिंगुलर, तो यहाँ पे सिंगुलर वर्ब ले रहा है. सो this rule is finished. Now there is a task given in this topic, this book. I believe now you all will be able to solve this by your own, and you can do it in your assignment work, and you can send, you can fill it in the book only. I think, and send it as the assignment work when your next assignment day will come. So dear student, now we have reached to the end of today's session, and we'll meet next day with a new topic of grammar book. So till then, bye, take care, and have a nice day. Thank you.